Hi everyone, this is Jack from MathsForge, and in today's lesson we're going to be plotting linear graphs for the negative axis. Let's take a look at our first example. Here we're being asked to plot y is equal to negative 4. So we've seen this in previous lessons. If you are plotting an equation that has a single variable and a single number, then that is done by drawing a straight horizontal or vertical line. For y is equal to a number, that's going to be a horizontal line cutting the y-axis at this number. So y is equal to negative 4 is a horizontal line that cuts the y-axis at negative 4. So it looks like this. And if we check our answer, there it is. We'll do another one-star example, this time with x. Here we're being asked to plot x is equal to negative 1. So where plotting y was a horizontal line, plotting x is equal to a number is a vertical line. And it's a vertical line that cuts the x-axis at this number. So it's going to be a vertical line cutting the x-axis at negative 1. There it is. And if we check our answer, there it is. Now let's do a two-star example. Here we're being asked to plot y is equal to negative x minus 2. So we're going to need to do a table for this. It's going to be an x-y value table. And make sure you have three spaces available to input your numbers. So we're going to have 1, 2, and 3 spaces available. I'm going to select some values for x. And from the previous lessons, we saw that selecting the simplest values are usually the best. So 0, 1, and 2 for x. So you actually select the x values, and you get the y values from the equation. So the equation tells us, okay, y is equal to negative x and then minus 2. So negative 0 is just 0, and then we subtract 2 from 0, which makes it negative 2. And now for 1, it's going to be negative x, so it's going to be negative 1, and then minus 2. So negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. And finally, 2 becomes a negative 2, because we're replacing it with the x, because we're replacing it for x. And then we subtract 2. So negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. These now become our paired coordinates. So 0 and negative 2 becomes a coordinate, 0, minus 2. And the same for these paired coordinates, it's going to be 1 and minus 3. And finally, the last paired coordinate, which is 2 and negative 4. We always start from 0, 0, the center. We're going to go 1 in the x direction and minus 3 in the y direction. So it's going to be here for the second point. And for the final point, it's going to be 2 minus 4. So we start from 0, 0, the center. We go 2 in the x direction and minus 4 in the y direction. We now connect these three points with a straight line. Make sure the line goes through all of the points and it covers the entire grid from end to end. There we go. And this should be the line of the equation y equals negative x minus 2. So if we check our answer, there it is. Okay, let's do a three-star example. Here we're being asked to plot y is equal to minus 3x. So just as before, we're going to start by doing an xy table, and we're going to make sure we have enough room to input three values for x and y. So I'm going to select 0, 1, and 2 for x. Now y, we can get the y values from the equation, so it's going to be y is equal to negative 3 multiplied by x. So negative 3 multiplied by 0 is still 0. Negative 3 multiplied by 1 is negative 3. And finally, negative 3 multiplied by 2 is negative 6. Here's the problem with the last one, though, the last point. Our grid only goes up to 5 and down to negative 5, so we're not going to be able to actually plot this value here. So what I'm going to do is as follows. Instead of selecting 2 for the x value, I'm going to select another number. I'm going to select negative 1. And we can do this. You can actually choose whichever values you want for x. But choosing a value like 100 doesn't make sense, since when you input it into the equation, your y value is also going to be large, and there's not going to be an area on the grid where you can actually place it. So always try and choose x values that give you y values where you can place them on the grid. We tried 2, it didn't work, so now we're going to try minus 1. So if we put minus 1 in place for x, therefore, to get y, we multiply x by negative 3. So negative 1 multiplied by negative 3 gives us a positive 3. And here are the paired values. So our first paired value is 0 and 0. Our second paired value is 1 and negative 3, and our last paired value is negative 1 and 3. And now if we plot these points and connect them, we're going to have 0, 0, which is right here in the center. Then we're going to have 1 minus 3, which is here. And finally, minus 1 and 3, which is here. So all points fit on the graph. Now let's connect them. So it's going to be from one end to the grid, going through all of the points to the other end of the grid. And there we go. This is the line that represents the equation y is equal to negative 3x. And if we check our answer, there it is. And that's it for the lesson on plotting linear graphs for the negative axis.